I required a hot air assembly rework station and found one for reasonable price on soldermall.com. It was the Soldron 8858 hot air portable assembly rework station. So after 2 days, I received the package. Let's open the package now. As you can see, it was fairly well packaged, so we can expect the product not to be damaged. After opening the first box, we can see there is the product itself, covered in bubble wrap. In the box, there also was the bill and some stickers. After removing the bubble wrap, we can see the marketing on the front of the box, and the box looks not damaged as we expected. First thing inside the box is the included power cord. Then there is the included stand and the replaceable nozzles. Then there is the hot air blower and the 8858 control unit itself. A thing to note is that all contents inside this product was fairly put in plastic bags, so I won't worry much about rusting or damage during storage. Let's take a look at all the contents now. The stand looks good, it's metal on the bottom and plastic on the top. The hot air blower has a plastic but rigid body and it is not much heavy. The control unit has a power in connector on the top, and at the bottom there is the proprietary connector for the hot air blower. This unit is also compatible with solder irons which uses this connector. There are 3 different sized nozzles which are fairly decent in quality. Let's set up this rework station, and being portable means there are only two steps to set up this. First is to plug in the power cord to the control unit. Notice when I turn the power on, it says OP, which means open. So what that means is there is nothing connected to the unit's proprietary connector. The next step to do is first look for a little notch on the connector on the cable of the blower and align it with the bulge on the connector of the unit side. And with that done, the setup is complete now. After we press the start button, we can set the temperature to what we want. This unit is rated at up to 480 degrees Celsius and 350 watts. If we press the start button again, we can set the fan speed in 10 increments. Now after setting the temperature, the blower will not start right away. It will only start when the blower is picked up from the stand. This is the auto cutoff feature that Soldron marketed. This feature basically works as the stand is metal on the bottom. There is a reed switch in the blower assembly which closes when it's put on the stand. Hence the unit knows that the blower is put down and the temperature starts to decrease. However, the fan in the blower keeps on going till the heater cools to about 100 degrees. Installing the nozzles is not much difficult, just align the dents on the nozzle and the blower. Now for testing it for SMD reworking. Let's bring out a test subject. I will set the temperature to about 300 degrees and start to heat the chip to melt all the solder joints and remove it. As you can see, it was fairly easy and there were no burning marks on the PCB. So, good job. This was my hands-on with the Soldron 8858 hot air blower portable rework station. I am planning to make a follow-up video after using this for a while, so do subscribe and press the bell icon to not miss my future uploads. If you liked this video and you found it useful, then please do share, like, comment, and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this.